Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode, and my name is Frederick Marwa. If you're new here, kindly subscribe below just to support my work and also to expect more weekly videos. Anyway, guys, today I'm talking about my experience in Panama. So 2 weeks ago, I was in Panama and I really experienced a lot of things. So I decided today, I just want to talk about it and at least try to share my experience to anybody who maybe has plans to travel to Panama or is in Panama either. So for me, I found Panama to be one, very expensive. For example, a loaf of bread that I buy anywhere else at $1.50, in Panama, I buy the same loaf of bread at $4 or $5. You see the difference? It's expensive. Two, the taxis in Panama don't use meters. Like, for example, other places you'll find taxis have these meters where you don't have to ask the taxi driver, like, for example, how much should I pay you? It has the meter. But in Panama, you have to negotiate, and a lot of taxi drivers take advantage of that. Thirdly, Panama is not safe. Yeah, for me, I was attacked in Panama by two ladrones, two thieves. These guys nearly killed me, man. They came with a knife, and they were like, give us everything you have in the... You are having... Like, man, it was like 1 minute of my life that I'll never forget. But I thank God that at least at the end of the day, I was able to manage them, you know, to manage them. And I came out safe, but Panama is not safe. Anytime you travel to Panama, ensure you are either walking in a group or, for example, you use taxis, or sometimes ensure you don't walk in the dark, you know, just safety measures. But I would say Panama is not safe, man. Yeah, for me, what I experienced in Panama, it was not safe. Yeah, man, I had to, like, you know, after the attack, I had to nurse my hand for like 1 week. And I thank my neighbors who really took a good care of me, and they, like, I don't know, man, how to say thank you, you know. They, like, washed my hand, cleaned my hand, gave me a lot of medication, and at the end of the day, at least my hand now is healing. I wish I could have shown you, but my shirt is on and I'm filming on myself. Anyway, guys, I think Panama is just a place, is just a nice place to visit, but not a nice place to stay. And also, maybe in the islands, it could be safer than in the city, because where I was attacked was in one of the main cages, main streets, or the main roads. It's called Via Argentina. So you can try to imagine that, like, I'm in one of the most famous streets and I'm attacked, and it was around 8:45 in the evening. Two guys came and they were having a knife and they attacked me. It was super horrible. But at the end of the day, I just managed, you know, narrowly. Yeah. And I screamed police, police, but there was no police to help me. People are just like, oh, you know, in town, sometimes people just see you being robbed and they don't like do anything. So that's what exactly happened to me. And about the nightlife in Panama, I would say the nightlife in Panama is not as vibrant as to other cities I've been, for example, in Medellin, Colombia, or in Bogota, Colombia. But I think maybe, you know, as you travel, you get to appreciate that other people party in different ways, you know. Other guys don't really make it super hyper, and other guys make it just, you know, a little bit. So, but it was still nice because there were nice people, beautiful girls. I'll say it all depends about maybe on, maybe, I don't know how to say it, but it was not as interesting as I expected. And the best thing about Panama is the islands. When you visit the islands, for example, San Blas or San Blas, I don't know the spelling, the pronunciation, but there are a lot of islands to visit, and also other places, very, very good places to visit, and that makes Panama a nice place to visit. Anyway, for me in general, my visit in Panama or my stay in Panama was horrible in that it was very expensive, it was unsafe, and also it was too hot, man. You know, we wanna go to a place where it's really nice and it's not super extremely hot like it is in Panama.
So guys, so far I've been touring around the city, but man, there's a lot of solar. I'm sweating like everywhere, including everywhere.
But anyway, maybe that's what we should expect in all coastal regions. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Kindly hit the subscription button here and also check my profile right here showing up just to subscribe to my YouTube channel to support my work and also watch these other videos about Panama just to learn more and more about Panama. I'll see you in my next video, which is coming very soon. Yeah. Bye. I'll see you later.